I'm so excited to have a conversation with my guest today. She goes by the name Delta the Leo. She's going to tell us who exactly is Delta the Leo.
Delta the Leo to many. Delta is my first name. I'm a dancer, choreographer, slash rapper, singer. I like putting that in inverted comma because I believe I am an MC and not a rapper. But they go link and link. I'm originally from Polokwane, Limpopo, Bapedi, Ralo, Chatovela. I'm representing all of y'all and all of the classes. Alexandra, Comora, that's where I'm also from, was raised. I'm known for dance, Machiga, Machia, you know, so that's how a lot of people know me. I've been in the industry for a minute, so if you don't know, better research it under dance, yeah.
Straight. All right. Thank you for being on our show, firstly. And I want to know what made you go into rap and hip hop.
Firstly, it was just the diversity.
Okay.
Hip hop is just so unpacked. Mm-hmm. You look at hip hop, it's all one element. It's the graffiti part of it. It's the breakdance. It's the music. It's the style. It's the core. It's the culture. Mm-hmm. So I was more drawn to that because of my, let's say, character. Because I'm such a out of the box type of person.
Okay.
So hip hop was just so direct, it was talking to me.
That's so more than anything, it's the movement for you.
Definitely.
Like following.
Definitely.
No, that's nice. Please describe your music style for me.
I make feel good music.
Okay.
When I say feel good music, wherever you are, when you listen to my music, it kind of places you in a different place. Whether you are happy, or you're feeling motivated, or you're feeling inspired. So that's the kind of music that I make. Not a specific, I make dubstep or I make reggae or I make R&B because I really do play around with different sounds. If you listen to my recent production, I have a little bit of reggaeton, I have a little bit of R&B, I have a little bit of dance and just a mixture of anything that you think is hip hop. You just throw everything in there.
Feel good.
And just feel good. Yeah.
Okay, and where do you draw your inspiration from?
I think this is so cliche, but everyone says it. Missy Elliott, growing up, I really, really looked up to.
Everyone loves Missy Elliott.
She's a powerhouse.
Yeah.
Anyone that's a sister out there that's into hip hop, the likes of Lauryn Hill, likes of your Beyoncé's. I'm drawn to women that like doing things themselves, and that's what I'm at with it. So, yeah.
And the type of music that you're trying to get across?
For me, I'm trying to fuse my sound internationally.
Okay.
With the likes of, like I said, Let It Be, it was placed in Coast to Coast reggae mixtape alongside Vybz Kartel and Snoop Dogg. So that's quite big for me.
Okay.
Knowing that if I experiment, so it's the life between your Patoranking to your Savage and just a little bit of dancehall.
Oh, okay.
So you have that African element,
but
it's subtle with a little bit of a dance. Fusion. So my sound is just, if you're playing it, I don't want you to think, oh, R&B, I'm depressed.
Yeah.
Oh, you go.
No.
Yeah. You just need to understand that at that time, whenever I wrote or whenever I write a song, it's in that present moment where I'm like, I'm talking about a feeling of being free in my hip hop space, or I'm talking, I want to be dancing, or I want to be inspiring, like when I drop Saga. Because I guess about anyone that's a hustler on the street trying to make their money, just minding their own. So it just goes back to that. You feel good when you have a message that someone else can relate to.
Yeah.
So that's the feel good.
I like that you said that you're not only focused on just internationally, like abroad, but also in Africa.
definitely.
I think it's very important because everyone just wants to go to America and just be a rapper.
Look.
And it's not enough. It's not enough.
We stand out, and that's a very, very beautiful thing about South Africa, being an artist from South Africa going out to the world.
Yeah.
I mean, right now I'm in the process of actually having a performance in Italy. So
oh,
that's
wow.
something very, very exciting to this girl, this aspiring rapper from
yes.
SA going to Italy
yes.
to just do my original material. So that's one thing. Not ignoring the fact that I'm also going to be doing a traditional dance piece
nice.
While I'm there. So that's
nice.
Just like...
So when is this happening?
This is happening in May. This
wow.
year.
I guess that's going to answer my question. My next question is, what is your biggest highlight of your career?
My biggest highlight, firstly, was being granted the opportunity to open for Rapper the Weeknd. Unfortunately, I couldn't make the trip.
You're lying!
Yeah. I was supposed to open for
wow,
the Weeknd in New York last year, July.
Yeah.
I'm one of those people that think longevity.
Yeah.
It didn't make sense for me to go and do one performance, rather stretch it out, really have a tour
wow.
that says Delta the Leos in New York and there,
yeah.
boom. You know, just so that you come back and you're able to inspire other women that are doing their thing. And I mean, doing everything independently is a little bit of a challenge.
But it's the best,
and
right?
it's the best because I'm learning the business side and I'm learning how to explore and test new things with the brand.
And
yeah.
you know how to read contracts. You have no
hustle. I mean, I didn't know. So,
yeah.
that does help.
Yeah. So, yeah. So that's your highlight career?
For me, that's my highlight. My other highlight would be having my song on Rhythm City, having my song on Ayeye.
Yeah.
I'm just like, what? You're watching TV and you're like, that's me. So that's
yeah.
really, really, for me, that was my biggest highlight, to be honest.
Wow.
Yeah.
And where do you envision yourself in like the next coming 5 years?
Worldwide, I see Delta the Leo music and dance traveling.
Mm.
And when I say traveling, it's just teaching people who you are, what you do, how to get there, starting where you are. Because you look at music now, there's so many record labels, you feel like I need to be there. And most importantly, it's for artists, you need to focus on yourself.
Mm.
You need to focus on where you want to see your brand.
Mm.
I don't want to see my brand as just music. I want to see my brand everywhere. If it's in a book, so be it.
Mm.
If it's on millions of billboards, so be it. It's just inspiring an African child and any child
yeah.
anyway from any background to say, look, it's possible.
Wow, I like how you say that you don't just necessarily take yourself as a musician.
Definitely.
You know, the fact that you're saying you are a brand and you stand for being a brand.
Delta
the Leo is just out there and worldwide.
Yeah.
That's incredible because most people just say, I want to make music. For as long as my music sells and my music is out there, that's all I want to be. I just
yeah.
want to be known as a musician. And I feel like that's what cuts the lifespan
yes.
of a rapper or
yeah.
MC
any artist,
or
yeah.
artist
definitely.
You know, a musician, because not many people think about the bigger picture.
Yeah.
And yeah, so.
Yeah, longevity is a very, very, very important part of anything. I mean, you can think about Masters of Rhythm.
Yeah.
How way back that
way
was.
Way back in the day.
And that's when,
so
and that's when I got my like
yeah.
my shine. And from
yes.
there, I was like, this is something that I shouldn't just, it's on the stage and off going. I mean, I go into communities and I teach dance.
Okay.
I give back. And that's how I see my work getting out there into the world, where you are touching lives,
mm.
where you're impacting people, saying, you want to make music. What do you have? Do you have a nearby studio? Do you know what you have to do when you get into studio?
Yeah.
How do you prepare yourself? Do you want to write your song? Do you get a songwriter? There's so many elements that go into that. And in this day and age, we have so many workshops for
yeah.
almost anything.
Everything.
You can take that into the world and
yeah.
say, in Africa, this is how we prepare our music.
So you want to do that? You
want
to start
I want to do that. Look, I won't start a foundation simply because right now, Live, Learn, Inspire is an active company.
Okay.
What I want to do is, from all the experience and business learned, whatnot, is to give back to the young talent.
Mm.
So learn to manage yourself.
Yeah.
I think a lot of times people look for managers to do all of that, and they complain, I'm not being paid, not understanding
yeah.
the work behind everything that happens.
Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah.
All right. Don't go anywhere, it's Sisters in Hip Hop, and after the break, we're going to continue having a conversation with Delta the Leo. And we're back. having a conversation with Delta the Leo. So I want us to go and have a conversation about the issues that have been tackling most of the women in the hip hop industry. So, I mean, the likes of misogyny, you know, lack of ownership, and also men feeling like they have the key to own our success as like women in hip hop. So I want us to actually talk about that. And my first question is, why do you think it's difficult for females to actually make it in the hip hop industry?
It first starts with the confidence.
Yeah.
I feel the one barrier, because it's so easy for me to be like, yo, I can rap and if I'm not carrying myself in such a way that the next person can feel that, you need to understand that presence can't be ignored. If I get into the room like, I'm down to the Leo, there is no way you are going to come and break me down.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, I've got my back against the wall, but it's not because I'm giving in to be submissive, you're a woman. I'm saying, I'm standing my ground. What do you have? And you look at hip hop, we expect it to not be tough.
Yeah.
It's like, be in the hip hop space, be the girl, take the yeses, be the model on the videos, and it's not the same. You know, you kind of need to wear the pants and say, look, rap is about being tough. Rap is about delivering. Just being in hip hop, you know, you're very
yeah,
strong.
Yeah,
you can't come into that space and be timid. You know, you kind of need to work on that confidence.
Like own it.
You need to own it, simply because men are intimidated by powerful, successful, or very driven women. You don't even have to have money or have direction. Sometimes you don't even know where you are going with the music. And if you don't already have that cutthroat, I know what I want, it kind of leaves little channels or little passages where, you know, the male factor are able to cut through. You've heard of so many stories where girls, you have to either sleep with the producer.
Yeah.
And you just only think about, do you want to look in the mirror and be confident that you got to where you got through the hard work? You know, or you got through what you got. And I say it because it's almost like a tongue twister.
Yeah.
Because what you get out is what you put in. So if I'm putting in so much of myself that is not truthful, it's bound to crumble.
Wow.
But if I'm fighting with honor, and sometimes honor is so fickle. You feel like, ah, it's just this one producer.
Yeah.
You're gonna
let
do
me do
this
it,
thing,
and then I'll be fine.
And then my song's gonna be on the charts. But then, how many of your songs are going to go through the same cycle? How much of yourself are you going to give up? Because you need to remember, your talent and your passion need to work together. If you're passionate, you won't let anything ruin that. You know, if you're truthful, if you're doing it for the right reason, you'll run that race. You will fall, you'll get up, you will run again, and you will fall. And the trick about it is getting up. And how you get up, that's your story.
Yeah.
You know, and with myself personally, I know it's tough. You find a guy that's like, oh, I like your sound. Oh, girl, you know, you're dope like that. I'll put you on. And it's like, hey, you know, can we go out for lunch? And you're like, okay, let's go for lunch.
It's free
food.
You know,
all right, cool. And it's like, no, I kind of like you. You remind me. And I'm like, no.
No.
It's not like
that. I said
let's
go out for lunch.
You know, it's not like that. And the very challenging part of it is having to protect yourself and protect what you're doing. Because so many people do that, and we've seen they kind of vanish from the industry.
Yeah.
And you're like, what happened? Because you can't face yourself. You can't deal with all of those faces. Because we don't know. It could be one, it could be two, it could be three. And
yeah.
The list is endless. And you are perpetuated to do things that you are uncomfortable with. If it's uncomfortable, I need to remove myself.
Yeah.
You know, and that also comes with how I was raised. I was raised by two strong women that believe you have to earn.
I guess also it's the pressure, you know.
Yeah.
Most, we succumb to pressure and say, this is what we want, so we're gonna go for it, and we just keep pushing for it. But at the end of the day, we just do it in like the wrong way.
There's
the problem.
There's pressure that is negative. And there's pressure that's supposed to push you to fight. And when I say fight, nothing worth having comes easy.
Yeah.
And when you realize the work that you have to put in, there are moments where I look back and I'm like, yo,
imagine if I didn't do this, would I be here today?
Yeah.
You know, imagine if I let that one person get away with doing that to me.
Yeah.
And that just becomes one of the things, being a statistic is never a great thing. So yeah.
With that being said, do you think with female rappers, there's emphasis on aesthetic rather than them actually having the skill of rapping?
It could go both ways, and honestly, it's a preference thing.
Yeah.
You know, it's so easy for me to say, Delta Leo, I'm a rapper, and I have someone writing for me.
Oh yeah,
it's so easy.
Writers,
you get what I'm
yeah.
saying? So it's a debate that you really don't get into
yeah.
unless you really clued up, because I cannot speak for someone else,
of
I can
course.
Speak for myself.
Yeah.
So with that regard, it's just how bad or how well enough are you equipped to be in that industry, because that also counts.
And as women, we also tend to divide ourselves in all industries. I'm not going to just say in the hip-hop industry. But why do we have that? And what could we do to actually fix it and not come together and say, hey guys, let's be about
yeah.
hip-hop, let's make some music, let's start our own movements, let's encourage
definitely.
Each other, let's hold each other's hands.
Why again, it's a confidence thing,
mm.
you know. Those that are feeling overly confident, I'm not going to work with so-and-so. I am better than them.
Yeah.
That I'm better than the next person. I am looking down on the next person. I've achieved.
Yeah.
Accolades and titles seem to mess up.
Mm.
You know, that sisterhood. Remember,
yeah.
sisters,
mm.
I could be a great dancer and you could be a good dancer.
Yes.
But how do we get there? Chewing a couple bones.
Yes.
We had a soul bone.
Yes.
You know, we dress
yes.
like this.
Yes.
Oh, this is how we grew.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
Whereas it's like, it's an one ball, I can't do this. You know? Whereas if we unite, and that's the thing, when you look at girls that have been in the biz together for a long time, you see the uniqueness in their work ethic.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, I will applaud you, I will congratulate,
yeah.
I won't fall down.
She
why made it before me.
Yeah,
why
her,
not
me?
Me?
Yeah.
And the culture of competing, instead of working together,
mm-hmm.
we want to compete against. And I am guilty of that, because you
really?
Feel you feel pressured to stand out. You're like, okay, they don't like me. Think badly. Hey, there's my hit. And you know they're sitting there like, oh, ish. You know, and she did it, man. It's hot.
Mm.
But they won't say, you know, D, your track is dope.
Yeah.
I actually like it. And I got out of that. I talked to myself and I was like, but why? Why don't I like that person? Because why are they better than me? Or are they? They're not better than me. I just need to congratulate. In that moment, they delivered something that I should be like, wow.
But also, don't you think it's because of mostly the mainstream girls? They mainstream. Delta is not really that mainstream. I mean, we don't hear
the
her on radio all
you
the
know
time.
What's the funny thing about that?
Videos.
If we were to look at your mainstream, right?
Yeah.
And not even accolades. If we had to look at mainstream,
yeah.
right? And be like, just looking at assets. I like thinking things that have value.
Okay.
Is your mainstream of value?
Mm-hmm.
Are you a brand of value?
Mm-hmm.
Do we look at you? Are you still combating a taxi like myself? Or are you whipping?
Mm-hmm.
Is someone investing? Are you doing everything? Because if we go and we break it down, who's working the hardest?
Yeah.
Let's really put,
yeah.
it's almost like doing a report.
Yeah.
Okay, yes, you are mainstream, but what do you have? Okay,
mm.
boom, boom, boom.
Mm.
What makes you important?
Yeah.
Do we really know what makes someone more important than the next human? As far as I look at it, we're all human, we are all significant.
Yeah. So for you, it's not even the mainstream girls, it's one of those work hard.
You just need to do you.
Yeah.
Knowing your lane and knowing what you're good at. The problem here is, like I said, we don't celebrate each other often enough. And when you do, you look like you're licking ass, for lack of a better word. Like, yo, girl, you don't. I've been in interviews where I've mentioned people's names and I've stopped because I feel like you're feeling entitled to that.
Mm.
You know, you're feeling entitled to, yeah, I know she's going to mention my name simply because they're assuming you want a collaboration. You want to be close, and it's not even like that.
It just happens.
When you even
an
see,
example.
when you even meet people in the mall and they don't see you, and I'm like, oh, the very same people that before they mainstream titles,
yeah,
it was so easy to be like, hey, you know, you're cool, I like that. So
yeah.
We all on different journeys.
Yeah.
Some want the fame, some want that attention, that I'm a mainstream. If I'm not impacting someone's life, like, yo, I show me, never show like, I want to be like her.
What do you want?
You know, what do I want? I want to be an icon. I want to be my, if I just said in terms of a visionary leader, I want to be the Oprah of my generation.
Wow.
In a nutshell. I want to be the Oprah of my generation simply because you look at Oprah and you listen to her story. Wasn't a pity party. It was hard. But despite the odds, she did what? She went and she got what she wanted. Same with Missy. She wasn't the small figure,
hot girl.
Missy's the biggest female producer that I can think of right now to our date. Music videos, she kills it. Production, she kills it. Music, she kills it. You can't even compare. And that's why I understand why some artists say, don't compare me, that's disrespectful, because our work ethics are not the same. You know, and that's where I see Delta the Leo. Where I want to be is that visionary leader. You should look at my work ethic and be like,
so I'm gonna sit there and be like, oh, damn, Delta.
And the nice thing about it, I want you to be like, yo, D, but how did you start? People are always shocked, like, she replied. Like, oh my God, I thought you were such a dude. I thought you were such a, and I'm like, no, engage.
Yeah.
I thrive so much on having a relationship. I'm a relationship person. Like, if we are not having a relationship, like, we keep it moving.
Yeah.
That's cool. No feelings, no attachment. We keep it going.
And we're back right here on Sisters in Hip Hop, having such a dope conversation with Delta the Leo. So yeah, before we go into the game, actually, I need to ask you more questions.
Okay.
Yeah, I have to. You're so interesting.
Do what you have to.
So it's no secret that misogyny is deeply instilled in the hip hop culture.
Right.
So I want to know, how does that affect the females who are trying to make it in the rap game?
How hard is it to be yourself? I think that should be the question.
Yeah.
Let's forget the labels.
Yeah.
How hard is it to be yourself?
Mm-hmm. It's the easiest thing.
So that answers your question right there.
Yeah.
That's what every woman should do.
Yeah, but I mean, some women are talking about resources, they're talking about how broke they are, they're talking about when do I even start?
Okay, let me tell you something. There's always a ask Opa or Matusa. A lot of what I've done personally, I've gone to friends, we've recorded in the most weirdest of studios, and you just like, let me just do my vocals, start with where you are. Because if I don't have the man, you know, and I know someone who can help, I show my issue, you know, you just have to speak to people, because it's just also like if you're looking for a job, and they're like, cool, shut up, you have to go for an interview, I'm a formal outfit. What do you do?
Don't talk about Bongadi.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So Bongadi,
I go pitch at the
Bongadi me. What's that day?
Yeah.
Chama, I can't afford to do studio now. Can I just do this one song? Can I just do this one song that I'm going to do so well? We do it there, you know, you write your paper on how to see the girl, that happens.
Yeah.
You know, do your thing. You have a plan for that song. Una which one, guys? Another phone. I can share that video again. We do that clip. How many clips have we seen that people have been given an offer to be in an actual studio?
Yeah.
Music video sponsored, myself included. I self-funded my first music video, right? So everything Waim, I saved up for it. Okay. And when I say saved up, no, when I say I saved up, this wasn't like top of the range, what one, man? Say hi, Rishile. And we did what hustlers do. Got a camera, got a group of friends, LXE, people showed me love, street was full. Right. And that will back when we do our dockies and when we do all of that, you'll get to see how much passion goes into something and how a community can really come together for you.
So that's what happened.
And that's what happened.
Okay. So the question that she said I must ask myself.
Pretty much
saying.
Yeah.
Well, no, you pretty much saying.
But we have that loss of
who are you?
Look, Bona. When I got in here, I told you, I'm good with faces.
Yeah.
So next time we go on, you know, we're hugging on that personal level. You know, that's what sisters do. You know, you don't have to ask someone, can you be my sister?
Yeah.
It's just love.
Yeah.
And it just flows. And I'm really big on energy. So I'm feeding off your energy, you're feeding off of mine. So
it should just happen naturally.
Come on.
And what strides should be taken in order for women to be respected in the same way as obviously
just respect
the males.
Yourself.
The males.
Respect yourself.
Mm.
The reason some men have the audacity to disrespect starts with you. You invite. Family. You know, no direction. What am I inviting?
Mm.
I'm not inviting people that are going to respect me. When you put her and you know who you are, you just like, look, born. And I'm not saying girls that I'm dressing are not respecting themselves. There's a different line, you know, just because I'm undressed or I'm showing skin.
And there's nothing wrong with that.
You know, because then you, there's so many connotations that go with so many things and you cannot live to, you know, be like, I thought that was good, she's not sexy, we're not going to buy her music.
Mm.
It's fine.
But you know what they say, sex sells.
But at the end of the day, you know, you're going to forget about that sex cell. Do we not listen to Missy? Please show me a video where Missy had to be like half naked.
Yeah.
You listen to Missy. Whether you like it or not,
MC Light.
Yes. Look,
there's so many.
The list is so endless.
Queen Latifah even.
When you make good music, you can't deny it.
Mm.
And you can only deny it for so long.
So women should actually fight to be heard.
Definitely.
With regards to their music. So the focus should just be making great music and not even worry about what the males have to say, whether you're sexy or not. It should all be in the context.
We should never have reason to, I need to explain myself. Delta, why are you not in a dress? Why are you not in shorts, bro? Preference.
When
we
all
have
preference.
You know? So it just so happens that we have different preferences. And just because I don't wear a dress, it doesn't make me less of a woman.
Yes.
And just because I have muscles, it doesn't make me less feminine. You know, so it just, different strokes for everyone. And
it just means we fit.
And you know, and it just so happens that you're going to find guys that like that.
Yeah.
Girls that like that. And some that just like, I'd rather listen to someone else who's showing me.
My last question, do you ever think it's going to end though? That the males look down on the females? Like, will it ever end? It's always been a thing that's been happening all over the world of hip hop. Not necessarily just the music.
You know, we look at the number of women that are in higher position.
Yeah.
In our country, globally, we are doing the things.
Yeah.
You know, and that's a revolution on its own. So, a matter of will it change? Definitely.
Yeah.
Actually, it has.
Yeah.
How many females do we have in hip hop?
Yeah.
And when I say hip hop, from your DJs to your graffiti artists to your
B-girls
to born, hip hop has grown. And it's grown to a point where the guys are like, yo, these women are giving us a run for our money. Because it's just, we are at that point where we are like, understand, we've got it.
We're dropping more bars than these men.
We've had it in catalogs, you know, so it's not even something that we have to debate. It's just artists need to respect artists because we also kind of take males, you know, or those that did it first. Everyone paved the way for someone else.
Of course.
It's just important to respect. And just remember that as women, we give life.
Yeah.
So what we are giving life to should have substance. It should build. Again, it should inspire. Because what music are we making? The young females that are coming after us should be like, nigga, I've got this.
Yeah. And they should actually look at making better music than you, the one that
they shouldn't be worried
to.
About the sexist battle that's
yeah.
going on.
Yeah.
You're an artist, deliver. And that's my approach, it's being that way. When I dance, it was the same thing.
Yeah.
I'd always be the only female battling the guys, but I'm like, let's get it in.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Yeah.
You know, I'm ready.
Okay, cool. Let's jump into our game. I'm excited.
All right.
So this is 35 seconds.
Okay.
So you've got your questions.
Yes, I have.
I've got mine.
All right, cool.
I'm going to describe it to you. You have to guess. So I describe
the
event. You know? Like, example, it's like Street Race 2, and then you'll say KFC. You know, because I'm describing what it is. So you have to guess.
It's about to be late for me.
But let's go. Alright, let's all try. Based on hip hop. This is all based on hip hop. So I'm gonna ask my first questions, right? I'm gonna ask the first one, and then you ask me, and then I ask the second one.
Why do I feel like I'm gonna lose?
Okay, do you wanna go first? You can go first.
No, you go first.
So I get the feel. Okay, cool. So it happens every year. In April the 27th.
Like today.
I like
you
so much.
No, I didn't.
Okay, no, you're right. Okay, cool. Super Mega.
Okay.
Yes. Awards that also happen every year in December that are done by the same people that do Back to the City.
The Hip Hop Awards?
You need to say it.
The SA Hip Hop Awards?
Yes. Okay, cool. First female to be signed under our family tree.
Nadia,
Makai,
yes. Okay, cool. And then K.O. started this record label.
Cash Tire.
Yes.
Wow, you know your hip hop. Okay, my turn.
You have to ask me, and then I'm going to ask
Yo,
you.
Yo, brother, what juice bag?
You should know him. He brought the juice bag, his name.
Oh, that's the singer.
Cool.
Abutiwa voice, the old Pisilis and Wale.
Oh, Questa, I'm giving you these things, by the way.
He has
what?
He showed his thing on social media.
Come back, Mom. Freaking hell.
Yes. Him. It's the blog that obviously puts on hip hop artists.
The blog?
Yeah.
It's like a like.
Yeah, there you go. And then she's a rapper, but we first saw her on a TV show. She's a female rapper, we see her on a TV show.
International?
No, South African. Okay, the show is Vuzu. And the rapper.
Oh, Nomuzi.
Yeah,
Nomuzi, my band man.
Yeah.
Okay.
Woo! Yes, us. Okay. Ha! Guys, too many questions. I don't even know who this is.
Okay, no, let me go, and then you go.
Okay, yeah.
Let me go. Cool. It's a beer, but with that brand of beer, they bring artists. It's like
Castle Light.
And then?
It's Castle Light.
Unlock.
Stuff. Yes, yeah, that's
Castle Light Unlock.
Unlock. Yeah, that's
okay, cool. Mr. Mutswako, the big guy.
Double HP.
Yes. So, Barakimang, Kulichana does these events.
Mufftown Heights,
yes. So it's a, it's a TV show. It's a music show.
Okay.
On if it's not on MTV Base and Trace, it's on
Channel O.
Yeah, and then the show is actually hosted by Scoop Makotimi.
I'm blank.
Okay.
Wrong. Street Journal?
No. Turn Up.
Oh, snap. Yeah, I'm not a TV
and
person.
And then The Late from Boom Shaka.
Lebo Mathosa?
Yes.
Shoo! Girl.
I got one wrong. So.
Yeah.
I gotta kill you.
Win.
Guys.
What is this? Okay, she has a song called The Ice Cream.
Oh, Gigi Lame.
Okay, he had an afro when he used to rap. It's a guy. He had an afro. He had an afro. And he called himself something.
Pitch black. Pitch black afro.
There you go. And then, yo, wait, guys, I don't know how to ask this. If you don't like chicken that you like in hip hop, what do we have?
When I don't like you.
Yeah. It's a show that plays music videos. Starts with the M.
You can't even say that. I didn't give you the rules, but MTV Base.
Yeah, well, you see this game. It's not fair, guys. Like, I need help.
It's like normal things.
Guys, I can't ask. This one, yeah.
Work.
That's the thing.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to help her out. And
I don't even
gonna
know.
Ask,
I'm
so
like
I can show her how it's done. Which one? Oh.
Yeah, girl.
Okay, now I'm going to try. So, A. Reese is a member.
Yeah.
Do you know it?
No.
No, but you already know the answer. Wrecking Crew, guys. Wrecking Crew.
Okay. So I'm laughing at you because I'm like, you should have skipped it because I was so
gone. But yeah, but that was such a fun game.
Yes.
So yeah, let me know, where do we find you? What are you up to? What are you working on? And yeah, just put yourself out there. Social media accounts, everything.
Delta the Leo. Yeah.
Delta the Leo.
Everywhere. So my music is available in all digital stores. You can follow me on Instagram, Facebook, on Twitter, on LinkedIn. You can check out my website, www.deltatheleo.co.za. Sounds like a rhyme, yeah? Y'all got that? I'm from SA. So do the right thing. Do follow me. If you have any questions, email me, info@deltatheleo.co.za.
100.
And that's also your bookings?
Yes. Yes.
And you're not performing anyway?
You're not fully
booked?
Yo, thanks.
Na, you know, these people out there, they will do some voodoo. Guys, to keep up with my gig guide, really follow me. That's how I keep it.
Yeah.
I told you, I like relationships. I don't like twara, you know? I like you to follow, and then you will know. But just so that you know, guys, I am leaving for Italy. I'm going to go represent South Africa, doing the most things. Yes, in Italy, I'll be dancing, I'll be performing. Yeah. I just dropped my brand new music video, my new single, so what you gotta do? Come on, they click, follow, like, listen, you know, it's a vibe. That's how we go.
Wow, it was so fun having you on the show.
Thank you for having me.
It was very, very fun. Thank you guys for tuning in to Sisters in Hip Hop right here on Sly Haze TV. Please don't forget to subscribe. Please subscribe, guys, or just go www.slyhazetv.co.za. I'm your host, Goons, and check you guys out again next week, Friday.